Hello, it's good to be back. For those who haven't noticed, I've been on sabbatical since the end of May, away from the normal patterns of church life and taking time to do all sorts of other things. I've read 18 non-fiction books across a range of theological and pastoral subjects. I've read 8 novels. I've listened to over 100 hours of the Bible Project podcast on topics including justice and spiritual beings and biblical poetry and exile. I've walked almost 700 miles, including the 84 miles of Hadrian's Wall. And I've done this without any music or audiobooks or podcasts in my ear, which has been strange. I've done it mostly in solitude, mostly in silence, seeking God as I go. I've made pages and pages of notes of things that have come to me as I walked, sifting them for the voice of God in the midst of my own thoughts. I visited 9 other Baptist churches and 1 or 2 non-Baptist churches as well. I've been on 1 mental health first aid course and I have been chased by 1 cow. You know, a few of my friends and family members have asked me over the last week or so how I'm feeling about coming back. I've tried to be truthful in my answer. I've been a mix of excited and anxious. Probably not much different from what children feel in going back to school after their summer holidays. Anxious about fitting back into routine, about what may or may not have happened that I don't know about yet. What challenges lay ahead. Excited to see people again, to be involved again. It's been hard for me worshipping at many different churches, but not having meaningful relationships. I think it's a little like visiting someone else's family for Christmas dinner. I've been made very welcome, but it is just not the same as sitting around the table with those you love. But the main thing that I've said about getting back is that I am ready. I'm ready to see what God has in store for the next stage of our journey together. I am ready to seek Him and serve Him here in this place. I am ready to laugh and weep with my church family again, to grow and learn and journey in the love of Christ together. I am ready for the next steps. I wonder if you are. I wonder what God might have been saying to you over the last few months. And in the next week or so, I'm hoping that as a church, we can consider all that we have seen and heard and what God has been saying and is saying to us. And that we can have some time to reflect how all of that fits with our God-given values of being Christ-centered and discipling and family and generous and missional and welcoming and worshipping. We're going to make time and space to discuss and to listen and to pray together about what's God been saying. So I wonder, what has God been saying to you? What has made you excited over the last few months? What have you found challenging or hard? What might be the next step in your journey with God? And what might our next steps together be?